didn't work out, but basically, it, in this stream, in this page, it mentioned why Paul Modrowski was convicted. Basically, it goes on to explain that the jury didn't like that he had no eye contact, had very little emotional expression, basically autistic traits. That's why he was convicted, basically, despite a complete lack of evidence. There was no evidence linking him to any of the crimes, just speculation. And he was convicted on pure speculation because the jury was not aware of his autism, because the stupid lawyer who knew that he was autistic didn't tell the jury that. Oh, wait. Not mentioning someone's disability is not important? Yeah, that's super important. And the thing was, he was a prime suspect at that time. So that was another reason the jury was so easy to convict him. Because they thought, oh, he was the murderer. But guess what? He wasn't. They were the murderers. Paul didn't know any of those people. Juan Luna and James Degorski, Paul didn't know either of them. Paul didn't know either of them. And I think, why did Robert implicate Paul? Just to get the police off his back. Robert Faraci is a backstabbing son of a bitch who is still scot-free, basically. Paul is serving life in prison for literally no reason at all. No reason whatsoever. And why did the police decide to make up allegations that Paul was, you know, lent his car? To retaliate against Paul for standing up for himself. Because while he was autistic, and is autistic, he gave the police officers a run for their money. Was not cooperating, was being very combative. But why is he being combative and refusing to cooperate? Let me see. If you're getting beat up and you're being treated like crap, I wouldn't want to cooperate with those fascist pigs either. You know what I say? Fuck the police. That's what I will always say. Fuck the police, fuck the prosecutors, fuck authoritarianism. People like that should be deported from this country. Scumbags like to beat up innocent people and try to get, you know, stuff done through violence and force shouldn't be police officers. They should be in prison. They should be with the very people that they consider criminals. And let's see what's going to happen then. Yeah. In fact, if you want to read about how Paul was just utterly mistreated, just go to his blog right here. Yeah, right here. So updates on the election. All right. The next court date is April 21st. Unfortunately, the thing never happened because of the coronavirus. Yeah. And they continue to just move the court date up, move it up. So November 15th, 2019. Paul wrote about his new school program. Oh, guess what? November 20th. Paul had a court date, and luckily the case was not continued again, and the judge rendered a decision. Okay. The judge handed down a 44-page decision where he threw out some of Paul's issues and approved others. This means for the issues he did not throw out, we're moving on to the second stage, which is an evidentiary hearing. We do not know when this will be, but we will keep you updated. Okay. There was the Palatine massacre and the presumed murder trial. The teenager with autism was held accountable for his actions. Yeah. And an investigator from the Crook County. Yeah, exactly. That's the police officers in most of Cook County are crooks. They're all fucking crooks. Every one of them. And the truth is, a lot of cops, not the cops, I don't mean the police officers, I mean the higher-ups, like the, that's how it used to be in the 90s. This is the scumbag. Boom. This is the scumbag that I hope will burn in hell. Like, I hope he burns in hell for all of eternity. Piece of shit, this guy right here. John Robertson. Oh yeah, he's a fucking prosecutor who got an autistic kid life in prison for something he didn't do. All because he didn't like Paul mouthing off to him and standing up for himself. Yeah, you ableist little shit. Alright, well, that's talking about the blog, and let's look at the other stuff. Older post. That's what I want to show you. Prison ID. About how Paul got Oh yeah, behind him, a man interrupted and said, yeah, this guy has a natural life sentence because of you. Luna defended him from him and said, well, you were convicted of something else. I said, you know, that something else is a load of bullshit. I meant to say, I did not expect you to turn yourself in. But what I want from you, and what I think is the least you can do is give me your discovery record. I told him that I did not want any information about him or Degorski. All I wanted was records pertaining to me and the police. I am looking for leads and for information on a dirty cop. He seemed relieved that this is all I wanted, and he told me I can definitely have the records. He told me no problem with it, however, he does not have them, his lawyer does. He said he would contact her and then give me her name just before the line broke towards different cell houses. Alright. this is the one. FBI agency. Robert, Paul Modrowski has right-wing views. Not far right, but, you know, right-wing. He's a populist. Thank you.
Fulton was the last prisoner in the world.
Earlier today,
look at this. And I endured hours upon hours of intimidation, threats, and physical abuse. Eventually, I made a few comments to my interrogators. which were largely twisted and became the basis of the prosecution's theory of accountability. John Robertson fabricated the story of how, while armed with a firearm, Robert told me he was going to kill Dean Fawcett and asked me to borrow my car. Although I was grilled about the Barrington murder for 2 days, only a couple of questions relevant to the Palatine case were asked. I remember toward the end of my interrogation, John Cozio asked me if I had anything to say about the Mercer murder. I ignored him, like I did most of the time. He said something like, "Oh, come on, you can't even answer whether you killed those innocent people at the restaurant." Finally, with him staring me down, I said, "Fine, I did not do it." The police arrested a former employee of the Brown Chicken restaurant the day after. His name was Martin Blake, and he was interrogated until the 11th of January. According to Blake's subsequent lawsuit and testimony at a pretrial motion of mine, his Miranda rights were violated and he was held incommunicado. He also accused the police of not providing him proper food, drink, or access to bathroom facilities, as well as all unlawful arrest. Although the Palatine police knee-jerk reaction would end up costing the village an undisclosed settlement, police were correct in their instincts. A former employee was involved in the mass murder. Juan Luna, had worked at the fast food restaurant but because a woman provided him with a false alibi, police did not pursue him as a suspect. It was not until nearly 10 years later that he was looked at again. Ann Lockett, along with Lenine Bakula, finally came forward to tell police Dia had been with Luna and James Degorski immediately after the murders. The two said the alibi was fiction, and the two men had discussed the crime in detail with them, including a never-before-released bit of information that one of the victims vomited french fries. They showed the woman the money they had stolen and gave them a portion of it. They were driven to the crime scene, which was then surrounded by police and ambulances. With so many leads that turned out to be false, the police were still not ready to arrest the two. Instead, they had Anne call James Degorski and tape him recording admitting to the false alibi of his friend Juan Luna, as well as incriminating statements. London police had kept the last meal, ordered compared DNA evidence with that of Luna. It was a match, and the Palatine task force made their arrests in the mass murder. Both Juan Luna and James Degorski made confessions to police. One even made one which was videotaped, and he described in detail the crime. According to one of Luna, they forced the owners to open up a safe, and after gaining the money, began to kill everyone in the restaurant. Degorski fired most of the shots, killing the employees in a .38 caliber revolver, which was reloaded. In the frenzy of the moment, Luna admitted to slitting the throat of one of the owners of the restaurant. Because he had worked at the place, he knew the best time to rob the restaurant would be at closing time. He had jammed the back door so no one could get out, and he knew it would be let in because the owners and workers knew him. The place was cleaned up, and after the murder, Luna thought nothing of the chicken he ate and threw the bones, partially eating pieces, into a garbage bin along with a napkin he wiped his hands on, leaving further evidence behind. Modrowski. You know how many years Paul has been in prison? So 22 years, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Paul has been in prison for, let's see, okay. Paul has been in prison for almost 30 years. Paul has been in prison for literally as long as I've been alive. When Paul was 18 years old, when I was just a newborn, Paul was in prison. Yeah. All for something he did not do. Basically, why was Paul Modrowski convicted? He was convicted because he was autistic. Yeah. Man, serial killer? Are you kidding me? Absolutely disgusting. Yeah. Yeah. set out to produce a serious murder mystery because there was no mystery. No one is looking for police, one on me.
I actually already have one. Actually, here's my petition right here. Yeah, there it is right here. I am actually... Exactly what I think. Kathleen, you think just as I do. Thank you.
they want to keep the gesture of guilt, you know, gesture of, we need to be tough on crime, tough on crime. Well, my ass. You know what? I am going to be going everywhere and signing, spreading this petition around until it gets... gotta go. Thank you for watching.